So just a little bit about the company. So it's about 10,000 owners, 9,900 owners, meaning that it's a cooperative. And in terms of milk, it's about 13.9 billion kilos of milk that we get in on a yearly basis, and that makes us the fourth largest dairy in the world. The products, it's across three major categories. So it's milk, yogurts, powders, and cooking. In terms of myself, I'm a manager in Arla IT. I've been with Arla for 2 years, and my responsibility is everything that's got to do with data and analytics and creating one data foundation for Arla. We started out with a source system, and we wanted to develop an application where we can predict the intake of milk into Arla. Then another part of the organization can see the benefit of the output that the application is generating, and they also would like to access the data in the source system. So another application pops up, and all of a sudden we have two sources for the new application. Still relatively simple, but then what happens is a third area of the business comes up, and they want to consume data from all of them, and so on and so forth. And this is very quickly becomes very, very unmanageable because of the complexity. We don't know where the source of truth is, and it's got a massive impact on our source system. If you take the same applications that still exist in Arla, but most of them have now been refactored into this type of setup, where we have one source, same source as before, we're ingesting data into the data foundation. We change the business. We change the technologies, we change the way that we're using our technologies. So, and finally, and probably most importantly, we've actually changed the forecast processes from being experience-driven to being very much data-driven. What it looks like is something like this. So this is the front page, very, very simple. You have an overview, and it's possible to go in and look at the total intake, the forecasts, and a number of different KPIs. So some of these are... When we first started with this in IT, it was basically the forecast that was important. So the rest is something that people outside of IT and the core team have actually done only using Power BI and simply with the knowledge that they have about the needs in the business. And again, these slides the numbers have been taken out, so there's more information on them, but it is possible then to dive into the data, do drill downs on the countries. This is showing actual intake, for example. What's also important for Arla is to know the percentage of fat and protein in the milk. This will give that overview. So this is actual data that we're showing here. If we move on, it's possible to compare countries. But most importantly, with this solution, we can then see that here is the we are seeing both the results from the machine learning model, the forecasted result, and the actuals, which is also what we're illustrating here, which is important for the business, and which is what they use when they're planning production.